Hello and welcome. Welcome everybody to GameGuru Max live broadcast number 59. I have more gameplay AI to show you today. But before that, a couple of little notes. One, you get to ask your question. So if you are lucky enough to join in the live chat, please ask any questions you want. Stick a question mark at the end. Towards the end of this broadcast, I will answer live your questions. Any ones I don't get to, I'll put them in the Game Guru forums later on along with a recording of this broadcast. And also want to make sure that everybody can hear me loud and clear. I'm sure some people have already anticipated the question, just want to find out for myself and for my sanity. Preben confirms, we can hear you, #. Thank you very much. Great, wonderful. Let's move straight on, shall we? I'm going to launch the software, show you a couple of things. Now, as you may know, just sort of to start the hour, pre-orders are now officially over. So thanks, absolutely thank you to everyone who's helped us during development with the pre-order process. We have now closed that down now until we release the product. And as everybody knows, we now have a release date for the early access version of GameGuru Max. So hopefully no more questions in that respect. So let me show you some stuff, some cool stuff. Now, last broadcast, it was behaviors, AI, logic, all that cool stuff. I've continued to work on that and shall continue to work on it, I think, pretty much through to release. I don't think we should downplay the importance of gameplay and the ability to be able to craft logic and have very impressive gameplay logic when you're playing against, you know, soldiers and melee combatants and things like that. So I'm not going to rest until I'm happy with it, and then my team aren't going to rest until they're happy with it. So it's really all hands to the grindstone now to make sure it's really cool. So let me show you a few things. The patrol one, you've kind of seen it before. Just want to click on this character. Already going off script. So you see here we have these behaviors. There's 9 of them. Well, in last week's build, they didn't entirely fully work. They all did something, but they weren't to my satisfaction. In this Friday's build, they all are correct. Now, so characters that's supposed to speak, so stand and speak, patrol and speak, get close and speak, they now come up to you and they speak. Zombies, act like zombies, soldiers will do things like soldiers should do by Friday. I'll show you a little bit of that in a few minutes. And of course, patrol, walk away, stand, huddle and wander, the simpler ones. I have improved the patrol. So now instead of just launching straight into a walk loop, it actually does a walk start, then a walk loop, then a walk finish. I've even added an animation. Don't have the animation yet, but the idea that if you think about a character who walks in a straight line, then turns 180 degrees and walks the other way, how would an actual human do that? Well, they wouldn't spin around as on a top. And the fakey trick is actually just doing a walk animation whilst you rotate the character. Well, I've commissioned an animation which actually has proper foot planting as an actual character would turn around 180 degrees. So I'm making a very comprehensive list of animations to replace pretty much every animation that you've seen so far in the non-zombie category. Because we want to make sure that we get great foot planting and also all the animations blend together and make sense. So I just wanted to divert to show you that all this is now available for your delectation. And as you can see, the one that this character here, I'll just zoom in a little bit. He has been selected patrol and speak. And I've actually added some of Lee's famous voiceover, so apologise. So you saw right then he span around, that will be that new animation, which rotates 180 degrees. You'll see that it's very subtle, but he actually walks smoothly on his spline.
Hello, this is a test of the speech system. I want to make sure my mouth is working as well as my eyes.
So there you go. You've actually got the gesture, I think, can be improved. But as I said, all the animations have been replaced. In the pathfinding, you notice that actually did a quite smooth turn as he followed his new flag. And also, it's more subtle, the head turns in advance of the flag. So the character looks where they're going to go next. And also, as you can see, you've got the head. Now the head's much smoother now instead of the old one because now it's decoupled from the script. So it doesn't matter if you don't have to call the Luke at play at every cycle now. You're just giving an instruction and the engine takes care of the smoothness of it. So that's just an example of patrol and speak, but I'm pretty happy with the behaviours now. But I know what you're really wanting. You want to see combat. Now, I can't remember much of it. I think I, last week I just showed you the character holstering and unholstering a gun. It's moved along since then. So what you're looking at now is flank. Now, forget the animation, but you can see the flank move and then the run. Again, the run is going to be pretty special in that the player will be able to look 90 degrees to his left or right, or her left or right, and continue to shoot you. So they'll be able to run circles around you whilst shooting you. Obviously this one. There you go. I just wanted to shut up for a minute so you could see it. But what you saw there was not only the character hunkering down, but he actually has a waist twist trick. So he'll actually move his gun to always point at the player. And when that twist gets too extreme, he runs an animation to actually shift his leg position. So he's then facing you again. So it's basically a 360-degree tracking of soldiers, both stationary. And for the case of moving enemies, they'll be able to shoot straight at you and run at 90-degree flank against you. Obviously, I didn't want to have soldiers that could fire whilst running completely away from you. Otherwise, they'd be holding the gun over their shoulder, firing blindly. Which sounds funny, but it's, I can't take that too seriously. So it will be a very, very low priority item if people want to see that. What there will be, and I'll be adding last, I really don't have any animations for it, I'm going to have to fudge it a little bit just to get it into the logic, is firing whilst stepping backwards. It'll be a slower movement on behalf of the enemy, but I've seen it a lot in games, and it's a good fighting defense, fighting retreat. So that's the third kind of movement. Attack straight at you, flanking side to side, and then a retreat, whether it's just running for the hills at top speed or sort of walking backwards whilst firing at you. And the thing that you've not seen yet, it's the one I'll be working on this afternoon, this evening, tomorrow and up to Friday, is cover positions. So the idea that you've got, let me just show you the second one. This is what I was working on to fix path finding. I'm pretty happy with it now. Obviously the, gosh, he's still shooting at me. There you go, let him just run for a bit. If I just show you the path. So you see you'll see like a red line. And that's basically the projected path of where the enemy is going to go. Currently he thinks he's flanking me. As you see, it's not perfect. I'm not happy with the paths that are being chosen. I think there's more intelligent paths this character can take. That's one thing. And also sometimes there's a little spinny as he gets to a corner, which is something to do with the implementation of choosing a direction and then setting a velocity. It's not the best way to follow a path line. So I'm going to re-engineer that so for the sharp corners, he actually literally slows down in order to take the corner. Just as you would if you was, you know, running and then you wanted to do a 90 degree turn, you won't be at full pelt, you'd slow down to make the turn, make the sharp turn. So those two things remain. Once those two are done, flanking should be pretty smooth, and then I add the new animations on and it'll be great. And as I said, the last thing will be cover positions. So instead of him just doing a sort of a yo, running all the way around me, obviously avoiding obstacles, he'll actually know where all the obstacles are and find great positions to hide behind. So let's say he's doing that shooting retreat, he'll be retreating back to a cover position to sort of get out of the line of fire. And if maybe he's really low on health, he just turns tail and run for a cover position. And two kinds of cover positions as well. One where you're completely obscured and one like a barrel or a sandbag where you can duck behind and take some pot shots. That's my goal for Friday. Whether I achieve it, I hope so. If I do things correctly and work smart, I shall be able to get all those into Friday's build. But those are the things that you can look forward to. And another thing I might have a play with is I wasn't too happy with my real estate on the behavior editor. As you see, the instruction blocks are now thinner, but they're still as high as they was, and I've really closed up the real estate. But as you can see, as say this is idle weapon state, it gets pretty complicated, and so I want to deal with that. But when you look at some of that, the flank state, all my decisions are on this side of the tree, so they just go off into infinity, and that's not really useful at all, just a big blank nothing. So I've been given the nod from the internal team to say, look, spend a bit more time on this. I know it's an internal tool. I know it's only a developer mode tool, but I think we can make a better use of space in certain scenarios like this. And also these flow lines of instruction going back to earlier blocks. You know, we want those to be a little bit more clear. Does that go to that or does that go to that? If lines line up, how do we know what that line and that line are actually doing, etc.? So a couple of little tweaks, but again, it's low priority because what I really want to do is get good flanking and good cover for you on Friday build. So that's what I'm up to right now on AI. I'm really enjoying it. The Recast Detour API, which takes care of the nav mesh creation and finding paths, is pretty neat. It has a billion settings, and I'm not completely happy with how it's dividing up the, that nav mesh. You notice those great big crates there? I reckon that player character could get between those crates, and as you can see, the nav mesh hasn't provided a yellowy bit to run between them, and I think that needs to be adjusted as well. So continuing adjustments of nav mesh generation and improvements of the pathfinding, at least in respect to how characters move and animate. So that, I hope you found interesting. This is what it's all about. These broadcasts reveal the inner development of what's going on. Warts and all. I have been given the slight nod to show a few warts. This is not what we was doing 3 months ago when we was only showing pretty much stuff we were happy with to release on Friday. But this Friday you're going to get, I would say, a first draft of the combat and non-combat AI. And I think from there, we'll start the iteration process. We'll start adding features and functionality and skills to the soldiers and the zombies so they're more realistic and more contemporary with modern games. So looking at the clock, I'm doing very well. I must be talking fast today. We have 3 minutes for official questions. I've asked for question marks. Let's see if there are any. There is a question mark. This is from DLS Lee. Looking forward to the RPG element. Can you please tell us what that will include and when you may have a rough idea when it be getting dropped? Well, dropped into the max engine. No, right. I thought it meant just dropped. RPG, I think, is one of our three strong genres that we want to support. Thanks for skipping all the way to next year. What will be in it, roughly, is think about you want to make a game where you're telling a story and you want conversations and you want narrative and you want cutscenes and scores and you want shopkeepers and inventory and quests you can go on and strange things that you've got to uncover and have lots of tools and gadgets for that. Again, you don't have to script, you don't have to create art. We will provide both. All you're going to do is come up with a great idea and start making your RPG game. It won't be massive multiplayer RPG everything. It is a single player RPG adventure that you can make in GameGuru Max. So hopefully that gives you a little idea. But as for when, it will be 2022. Okay, looking for another question. A question from Martin Oliver. Question. Simulated sky seems to degrade performance quite a bit compared to static skies. Yeah, there's a lot of processing going on. The skies that you see are generated in real time. We have some other stuff which is volumetric, which probably even more performance hit. But you do get the choice. You know, if you're aiming for a lower spec machine for the games that you're making, then just stick to static skies. It's all really about, you know, what your target audience is. But certainly with the graphics card I have and the team have, and they're not fancy new ones, the GTX 960s, 970s, things like that, then the sky, you know, poses no issue. The rendering of 10,000 trees is one thing we're tackling in the immediate future, which should worry you more than sky. But the short answer to that is if you get more performance with static skies, choose static skies. There is a cost to real-time cloud generation. Here's a question from Synchro62. Why we have proper can we have proper controller support this time so we can stream our games to mobile devices? That is planned. We are planning to actually have controller support. Not a comprehensive set, because I'd have to own like 20 different controllers. I've been down that road before. You just end up with 20 controllers and tripping over them. I have a few controllers and I will get those up and running so you don't have to use the keyboard and mouse if you don't want to. And that has certain pertinence as well when we start looking at VR and the different control modes that we need to introduce for that. Here's a question from Nobatsoul. Will you be adding the new Wicked Engine update for 2021? Yeah, I don't see why not. We already have stepped up. It's an internal build right now, but we've already stepped up to a newer version of the Wicked Engine, and I think we may do that one more time. Obviously, we can't keep updating to the latest Wicked every week because it sometimes breaks things. But we certainly will be taking advantage of any of the nice shiny new toys that may have been introduced, say, up to the end of this month. But probably we'll start doing a cut-off to make sure that stability rules, because we need to completely understand the engine that we're sitting on in order to do all our own stuff. And we are doing a lot of stuff around the Wicked engine as well. In fact, a lot of the terrain system's completely customised. So when you get that scenario, we've got a lot of our own stuff and the Wicked, it gets merged and updated, a lot of things may break. So we're aware of that. Here's a question from Saint Beezlebub. How large can a single level be before performance degrades, or is it too early to tell? Well, I can tell you our terrains are massive. Super massive procedural terrains. So when you think of scale, it will be massive. The better question is, how many 1 million polygon objects can I keep dropping into my level before my level degrades? Well, then the answer is, how long's a piece of string? And some people know the answer to that question. It really is how much you're cramming in. What's your minimum spec? Like every game developer, you will have to make the decision of how much to put in your level. What I can say is, thanks to the Wicked engine, it is a commercial strength, highly performant graphics engine. So don't worry about the graphics too much. And we're also very concerned about making sure that all of the other elements, for example, our terrain, the speed at which the AI works, the physics, all of those are doing well. So don't worry too much about any one section being underperforming. But again, it's the old rule. If you cram too much into your level, it will naturally be slower than someone who's just got a building in a level. So looking at the clock, I've gone over my 15 minutes, so I'll answer two more questions from people who've not asked a question before, and the rest you'll find in the Game Guru forums a little bit later today. So who's got the lucky opportunity to get a question? You've not asked a question before, you've asked one. Super confident man hasn't asked a question before, so here it is. Will there be a breakable glass and destructible objects, including the structure editor? The structure editor will remain in developer mode. As for breakable glass and destructible objects, no, that's not in the current plan for the release. I like the idea, and I've got a couple of different approaches to how that could be. Traditionally, you'd have an artist create all the different fragments, and then you'd have to do all the work to sort of synchronize having that object detector break, and then you create all the particles and all the rest of it. Kind of walking away from that idea, because I think you don't really have an artist on standby to make all these bits for you. And it's a lot of work for us to take 1,000 objects and break each one up. So I am leaning towards the dynamic destruction approach. So taking an object and then having some sort of Venturi crack algorithm and just split them apart, fill in the interior textures, and then boom, you've broke something. It won't be as good as something that's been tailored. And of course, that can still be supported. But for destructible objects, no, not for this first release. And here's the next question mark, four question marks. This is from the Mimondo. I see the name in Game Guru forums many time SI. Who is Lee? Are you Lee? I am Lee. I am the Game Guru Max lead developer of a very strong and excellent team of developers making, I think, is going to be one of the coolest game makers of 2021. But that's just my opinion. But in answer to your many four question marks, my name is Lee Bamber. I am the CEO of the Game Creators and the lead developer on Game Guru Max, and proud of it. So thanks very much for all your questions. The rest I promise to answer in the forums later on. These broadcasts happen every Wednesday at 4 p.m. BST. Unlike my usual outro, which suggests you go off and help us with the pre-orders. The pre-orders, as I said before, have now closed. The good news is anyone who's already a pre-order user will continue to get the Friday builds all the way to release. And in addition to that, I will continue to broadcast every Wednesday at 4 p.m. BST. And the next time we'll do that is next Wednesday. So I hope you enjoyed this broadcast. I hope you enjoyed what we're doing so far. I look forward to bringing you more many things next week. So until then, I shall say goodbye. Thank you very much.